Everyone, very good afternoon. Starting the class late, okay. Just want to, you guys to see the lecture that Dr. Tay already planning, right? So today is the first lecture after, I can say it's a last lecture. It's not like lecture because I still don't have any, equipment for doing a whiteboard presentation and so on. But in all my best to understand that left on CO happened. Okay, sorry about the some masak sound in the lunch for me. Perhaps. So, are you guys clear me? Clear? Hearing my voice? Or you hear the sound of... Masak-masak tu? Never mind. sound good background, eh? Masak is okay, eh? Are you disturbing with that sound? So let's continue where I have stopped before this. Okay, just to remind you, in 7th of July, and then next week, okay, let's try to some of the questions that will be given to you lah. Actually, it's not really hard. And then we'll answer the question open book. Open book, right? So I don't think it will be a problem for you. Why the exam is 4 hours? 4 hours? So you have time to answer the exam. All right. So cannot lah. Okay. Only 4 hours lah. Okay. Because there is some scenario. Okay. In terms of this kind of exam, and then this kind of, you know, the new norm, new norm. So, like not good in forest. Why you stay in forest? So we give you some we call it adequate time for you to answer the question and then submit the result, submit the your answer. But make sure on the time being given for you doing the final exam, you must be there. And then, okay, even you have problem to submit, I think most of it you can submit lah. Any problem during the midterm lah, everyone can submit. Although it's past the deadline, also you can also submit. What's bad? Midterm. Same as the midterm. Okay? You need to answer number of questions. And then, what we will discuss next week. How many questions and everything we discuss next week. But pipeline will be there. That's why we have a lecture about pipeline and then the sum of the computer. I think computer performance, I'm not sure. Right. Next week we will discuss on it. But today, let's focusing on the I have left you behind lah on this. Okay, because in final the question will be on the associative mapping. The type of question is not like the midterm. Okay, some ada sedikit perbezaan lah. Okay, the way we ask you the question. Okay, rasa there is a one tutorial question regarding on that. You can look onto the tutorial, another tutorial, cache tutorial, cache memory tutorial question. Okay, never mind, we that question because I think Dr. T have uploaded that one. But you can see that is the kind of question you need the final exam lah. Okay, so let's go through about the Okay, let's go straight away to our lecture. I've been explained about direct mapping, right? So just to recap, right? So direct mapping, this is the structure lah. Okay, word bit, line bit, and tag bit. I expect that most of you has been already know lah. Regarding this one. Hold on, ada apa masuk. Itu yang saya malas ni. Ya. Bahasa macam ni. Alright. So, this is the example of 24 address. Tag, line and word. Alright. So, may I ask you, should be no problem on direct mapping, eh? Alright, everyone okay, right? In direct mapping. Alright, so what is associative mapping? Compared to the direct mapping, address must be put into the specific line. Okay, line by line and then so on. Okay, so that's why in direct mapping you have a line or slot number. Slot number. So basically, the of the main memory will be put into the line specific, the specific line. Okay, so associative mapping, those can content of the memory can be put in any line of the cache. Okay, you boleh masukkan dalam mana-mana line of cache. The only difference is when is the mid-term result. Okay, later on. Okay, we'll update you later on. Don't worry. Okay. Alright. Main memory block can load into any line of cache. And then the memory address is interpreted as tag and word. Okay, compared to the direct mapping, you have three, right? Line, tag and word. Mapping you ada, tag then word. Okay, tag ni yang akan identify the of the memory. Tag uniquely identifies the block of the memory dalam cache tadi, dalam memory je lah, main memory. Okay, so every line tag is examined for a, so semua tag tadi dia akan examine, akan compare which one sama dengan main memory dengan cache tadi tu lah. Okay, sebab dia dah tak guna konsep line tadi, konsep line dengan tag. Kalau tadi tag tu dia dah dapat tag, dia can just straight away go to that line. This one you search every tag. Okay, associative mapping make the cache searching gets expensive. Okay, so this is the format for the associative mapping address structure. 22 bits for tag number and then the word is the 2 bits. Okay, word is 2-bit. So 32-bit tag store with each 32 data. Okay, apa maksud dia? Okay, based on the diagram tadi. Okay. Okay, so bit of the data. Okay,
Alright. So this is the data. Data size of 32 bit. Alright. Ingat kan saya cakap 1 4 bit. Ah, 1 hexan nama is 4 bit. So you have apa ni? Banyak betul dah. Ah, you ada 8 hexa number. So 8 times 4 is 2 bit of data. So 22 bit text store with each 32 bit block of data, meaning that so 32 bit daripada sini address, 24 bit address, where 22 bit is for the tag that mapping with the data. Alright, 2 bit is for the word bit. Okay, is for the word bit. I think I have explained for you about the word bit lah. Alright, you must understand now. You must be understand for now. So the process is you compare tag field with tag every in cache to check for the heap. You know right? I said when the instruction request a specific address, they will check for the tag number on the each tag number dalam cache tadi, and then kalau ada dia akan panggil heap. Okay? So can to be said identify with ambil word lah. Okay, 8 bit like cakap tadi, 8 bit word is required from 32 bit of data block. Right. So this is the example. Okay, for the address FFFFC, one is 24 bit of address. 24 bit address. From the 24 bit address, 22 bit is FF. Okay. Yeah. How I get that? Okay, so FFC daripada sini, alright, 1 1 1, nampak tak? Nampak? Ya. Yeah. Tak nampak eh? Ah, 1 1 1 1, eh 1 1 1 1, okay, 7 7 4 5. So C is what? 0 1 1 0 0. Okay. So basically untuk tag is 20 bit. Alright. So this is for W. Okay. So let me see. This one is for. Okay. This one is for tag. Okay. So now your tag is. Okay, so your tag is right. Jadi, your tag dah jadi learn. So this is tag number, right? Okay. dia punya address hexa, you need to divide as a 4 bit number, betul? Okay, so this one is apa? So satu-satu apa? 1, 2, 3, betul? So F 5. Okay, itu yang tadi tag dia is 3FFFF. Alright? Okay, saya bagi satu contoh. Cuba kalau apa ni? Okay, so tengok contoh ni. Nanti final nanti next. Let's see the example. Okay, so if this one same as I show you before, right? 1 0 0 0. Okay, 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 0. Okay. Okay, so your tag is, saya pakai Mac ni saya, okay, alright, okay. Aku tidak betul lah pakai Mac ni. Okay, alright. So this is your tag number. Okay. Ada juga orang nak masuk. Yep. Okay. Alright, so this is your, okay, so how to get the address for tag, divide, macam mana silah, 4. 3, 4. Okay, so this one is, apa? 10 is 2. Alright, 0, 9, 8, ni apa? 1, 2, 4, 4, 8, 10, 14, 14 is, apa? D D lah. Okay, so, hexa. So 20958E for the tag address. Okay, so macam itulah carinya. So I'm sure that you already clear lah how to get the address from the binary to hexa, hexa to binary. Supposedly you know about that. Oh, do we need to put hexa symbol? Remember, as I said before, the only number that you do not put any notation is 5. Okay, what is the difference between 101 and 101b? 1 is 101 in decimal. 101b is 101 binary. Okay, so any then decimal you must put. Kalau tak, nombor dia adalah nombor yang bukan binary atau hexa. It's a decimal number. Alright. Okay, so this is the summary. Alright, basically address length, macam saya cakap lah, 24-bit. Basically is S plus W bit. S is tag. This one is tag lah. S is a tag number. Okay, so number of addressable unit. Power of S plus W. Okay, words or byte. So meaning that unit that you can have in the memory. Okay, block size is equal to line size, which is 2 power of W word. Remember lah, I said this one, size dia berapa, berapa word. So kalau 2 power 2 is 4 word ataupun byte. 1 byte is 8 times 4 is 32 bit. Okay, number of block in main memory, 2 power of S plus W divide by size block tadi. Baru dia dapat of block tadi. So senang cerita 2 power of S lah. Okay, 2 power of S yang tag tadi. Number of line in cache, ni yang undetermined. Basically, cache is based on the programmer decide if you do associative mapping. Okay, determine the number of line size. Basically is cache size ataupun block size lah. Okay, how many block size we have? Itulah number of line dia. Alright, size of tag is S bit. Okay, size of tag is S bit. Ni lah yang last, yang ni tadi. Tag tadi lah. Okay, so this is the example. Okay, the example of associative mapping I have shown you already, right? Okay, you have the set of memory in memory. Okay, any data in the line of memory can be put in the any line of the cache memory. Okay, this is a 16k thousand of line cache. Okay, they have a 16,000 line of cache, the line number lah. Okay, tag number. Okay, basically line number is the last of the, say here tag size is this one, 3FFF. Yang ni tadi, yang you made from here lah. From here, FFFF, ni FFFF, C kan? Okay, just want to determine mana satu address di dalam ni yang kosong-kosong. Okay, so basically that one determine the, alright. Okay, so any question on associative mapping? Any question? Hopefully you know lah. It's just straightforward. It's just a straightforward mapping, line mapping lah. Alright. Okay, how we go for set associative mapping? So basically, what is a set associative mapping? Alright, it's a compromise that exhibit the strength of both the direct and associative approach, while reducing their advantages. Okay, as you know, associative mapping also they have their own advantages, disadvantages. Direct mapping also have their own disadvantages. So set associative mapping is basically the hybrid of the and direct mapping. Okay. Alright. So it is a cache that consists of number of set. Contains a number of line. Alright. Meaning that they use the concept of direct mapping. Direct mapping. So in direct mapping, you have line of cache. Okay. But in set associative mapping, you have number of set. Okay. Of set, you have number of line. So a given block maps will map to any line of a in a given set. Map to any a given block will map to any line in a given set. So you have one set, but you can have a different line in the cache memory. Okay. For example, two line per set, okay, which is two-way associative mapping. Block can be in one, two line in only one set. Okay, in one set they have a block cache study. Alright, so let's see mapping from main memory to cache with the K-way associative. This one is B associative map cache. This one is direct mapping cache lah. So they basically they merge into this technique. Okay, this one is associative mapping. B ni maksudnya ada dua lah, satu dengan dua. Kalau tiga way, tiga lah. Alright. So any line of this memory can be put in any line of this cache. This one is associative mapping. Dalam direct mapping, only map into the specific line in the cache. This memory can be put into this line or into this line. Because you ada dua ni tadi kan. They say a set. This one yang kita panggil adalah satu set. Contoh satu line ni, ini kita panggil dia satu set. Dalam satu set ni ada line. Faham? Sebab dia adalah two-way set associative. Alright, two-way set associative. Kalau kita ada three-way, jadi kita ada satu lagi set cache memory block. Okay, basically satu set dia akan mengakumi untuk tiga tadi. Ini it contains of three lines. Okay. Faham eh? Okay. Alright, so let's see the example. Okay. For this example, alright. 9-bit for text, set is 13-bit, and word is 2-bit. How you tengok this kind of address structure with the direct mapping. Same, tak ada berbeza pun. Instead of you are doing a line bit, this one you use a set bit. Okay, set bit. Okay, kita tengok apa function set bit. Basically kalau kita nak tahu, bit is how many set then you can have cache memory tadi. Okay, so basically use a set field to determine the cache set to look in. Set field ni nak tengok set mana. So let's say it's a two-way set associative, meaning that this one dalam satu set ada dua line, cuma set dia berbeza-beza. Okay, contoh ni. Okay, it's a two-way set associative mapping. Alright, so basically you ada okay dua set. Okay, so kalau you tengok dekat sini, set number 0 to C. Sorry. You tengok set number sini 0, 1 until 1FFF. Okay. You can have the number of set is 2 power of D. Okay. So, itu yang tadi. Kalau 2 power of. So, anti 000 anti 1FFF. Okay. Number of set that you can have in the. Alright. So, kalau you tengok set 000 until 1FF. Value that. Because it's a two line. So, you ada two line. One line, second line. Have a different tag number there. But the same set number. So, kita tengok dari mana data ni. Alright. This one is came from here. Came from. Faham? Alright. So, contoh ya. Daripada gambar ni. Bawah ni. Jaya. Okay. So, saya ambil contoh ni This one So this Ya, sini ada kan? Ni. Okay. Alamak. Sekejap So, alright. Kalau itu kat sini. Ni. Itu saya ambil sini. Alright. Okay, 176 dengan Alright. Mana nak break space lah. So this one. Okay. Oh, okay. Go now. Right. So kalau you tengok kat sini, so one is mana ni? Ha ni. Alright. So tag is 9 bit, 13 bits and 2 bits. Okay, basically how dia dapat macam tu. Okay, you tengok daripada this one 16K line cache. Okay, so 60K line 2 bits, I think I already explained to you. So I expect that you all know it's based on the of the data. So that's why it's 2 bit. Eh? So now where did they get the, okay. Ya, I pun open kat clip ya. Okay, so 2 power of 8192, 2000 of 13. So, it say here is 9 cache, 16K line cache, and you already know that is a two-way set associative. So basically if 16,000 you divide by 2, you will get roughly 8,000, right? Am I right? So that's why the set will be 8, okay, because 2 power of 13 is 8,000 plus plus. Okay, so meaning that from this line cache you have set 8,000 of set because it's only two way, faham eh? Two line in one set. So, you faham tak situ? Boleh eh? Ha, sebut sejak ni boleh lah. Alright. Tak, saya minum air dekat kiri. Okay. Alright. So that's why you got a 13 bits there because it's a 16K line. You divide by 2. Right? 2. Because it's a 2 way. Okay. So 2 power of 13, you get 8,000 something. Alright. So this one is 13 bits. So how many tag? Let's say the address length is 24 bit. You minus 13 and minus 2, you will get a 9 bits. Okay, so from here, this one you can say as a, okay, and then 30 bits is for the set. Okay, 2, 4, 9, 1, 3. Okay, so this one is the, this one is for the tag. Okay, so this is the tag number. Okay, so let's see. Okay, we have the set number first. Okay, the set number. Okay. So this one is right. Satu F. Right. Okay. Satu fungsi. Right, so this one is set. So then you have a okay. Right, so your this is the tag number. Okay, so your tag is 0 C. So, kalau itu kat sini, ni. Okay. 0 to C. You ambil daripada sini. Sorry. This one. 0 to C. Lepas tu ada satu lagi ni. Okay? Boleh? This one. Betul lah. 0 to C. You tarik daripada sini. Okay? The tag number is, looking for the set number first. 1FFH. Okay? So this one. 1FFF. Ni, XR. Tag number will be 0 to C. So kita tengok satu lagi. Address. Which is, Sekejap. FFC. Okay. So basically this one is okay. So this one is good. Right. So another 13. 2, 5, 6, 7, 17. This one is. Okay, so let's see for the set number, the set number. Betul lah juga. This one is sama. 1FFF. Periksa. Okay. So it F right. So kalau itu kat sini, you have a same set. Then this one is the tag. Okay, so set number is same. One set number, you have two line. One is 0 to C, one is 1FF. Okay. Okay. Boleh eh? It's not really difficult actually. As long as you understand the structure. Line be divided into the similar set. Okay. So as I say, one set can have a two line if a two-way set associative. Kalau three-way, same. One set can have a three line. So if one set can have a four line and so on. Alright? Okay. So if it's two-way, yes. Have a two line. Macam ni lah contoh tadi. Like this example, okay? One set number can have a two line, satu, dua, okay? One set can have a two line, two way. Kalau tiga way, one set can have a three line, satu, dua, tiga. Alright? So that's the thing lah that you need to understand actually. Alright. Okay. So basically this is the summarize lah. Basically address length. Mana jadi? So address length is S plus W lah. Basically S is the whole from here, S. And set, so that one is S lah, plus W bits. Number of addressable unit, 24 bit is 2 power of 24 lah. Okay, basically address length we already give you lah, it's a 24 bit or 32 bit or any address bit, any address length can we size, is a line size, basically is W lah, plus the line size, 2 power order. This one I have explained you more and more, alright. So number of block is basically, alright, this one same as the associative, 2 power of S. The whole block is here, okay. Exclude the okay, number of line in set, number of line in set is K lah, 2. Kalau 2 way, 2 lah, number of line in set. As I said, right, one set you have 2 line. So if 3, so it's 3 lah. Okay, number of set is 3. Okay, number of set is 2 power of D. This one. Okay, size of set is S minus D. Okay, so number of sets is V, where 2 power of D lah. Alright, so 2 power of, let's say 13 bit for the set is 2 power of 13. Number of line, you just times 2. 2 power of 13, you times 2. Like I said just now, 2 power of 13 is 8,000 plus. So how many line? So times 2, because one set have a 2 line. That's it. Okay? Alright, so any question? No problem, Okay, so, okay, for the replacement algorithm, okay, as I mentioned earlier, earlier during my our lecture, okay, in the cache memory, the cache, basically the programmer has set the time to live on each memory. So how they do that? They use the replacement algorithm. Okay, so what is the purpose of the replacement algorithm? Okay, once the cache has been filled, so a new block can be brought into the cache where one of the existing block must be replaced. How to do that is based on the programmer lah. Alright, only one possible line for any particular block. No choice for direct mapping, because place you must be put back into the same block lah. For associative and set associative, the replacement algorithm is being needed. Okay, direct mapping you tak perlu, direct ni replacement algorithm you can just put, because okay, line tu you boleh replace dengan line tu saja, you tak boleh nak tukar-tukar. Okay, tapi basically algorithm must be implemented in the hardware lah. Alright, most common replacement algorithm. I think in the final exam there's been question on this thing. Please read more lah. You need to read more. I can explain just brief. So if you want to do, if you want to know more, can you read? You can read more lah in the textbook. Okay. List recently used. Why is least recently used? Basically, this one is the most effective. Place that block in the set that has been in the cache longest with no reference. Huh? Okay. Replace that block in the set that has been in the cache longest with no reference to it. Because of its simplicity of implementation, so that's why LRU is most most popular replacement algorithm. Then you have the first in, first out. Basically, first in, first out is replace that block in the set that has been in the caches, the cache longest time lah. Okay, because those block, the first one came into the cache, it will became the last one to be replaced. Okay, implemented because you use the as a round robin ataupun kita panggil circular buffer technique lah. Alright, you know right the buffer right, the first one in the one that one first and then dulu lah. Okay, and then least frequently used, this one concept that the data in the cache that least frequently used will be replaced. The new cache punya members lah. Okay, so replace that block in the set that has experienced the fewest reference, meaning that tak ramai rujuk dalam the cache tu. Bukan tak ramai, instruction set of RAM doesn't to the block of memory frequently. So this one they've been replaced lah. It could be implemented associating a counter with each line lah. Alright, so this is the type one, the type of the replacement algorithm. Okay, then write policy. Okay, so write policy right into the cache memory lah. So when a block that is resident in the cache is to be replaced, to consider that if the old block in the cache been altered, then it may be override with a new block without first writing out the, if at least one write operation has been performed on the word in that line of the cache, then main memory must be updated, okay, by writing the line of cache out of the block of memory before bringing the new block. Basically this one, you did not want to have a conflict between, as I say, cache memory is referred by the instruction, by any instruction, and any changes on that you must do also in the main memory. So that's the brief explanation lah. Okay, so there are two problems to contend. More than one device may have access to, okay, a more complex problem occurs when multiple processors are attached to the same bus. Cache. This one, how the cache must be tally with the main memory. Okay, because any changes you do in cache memory, you must update in the main memory. Because that one you refer lah. Yeah, you refer. You refer the those memory in the cache memory, those data in the cache memory as actually is being referred from the main memory. So any change you must main memory. Okay. Right, so this is one of the method, okay, to cater those problems that I've mentioned just now, okay, which is two type, write through and write back. So write through is a simplest technique. All write operations are made to main memory as well as to the cache. Any alteration in the cache memory, so operations are the same in the main memory. You change in the cache memory, you will also change the. The main disadvantage of this technique, it will generate the substantial memory traffic and may create a bottleneck, because any changes that you do in the cache memory also changes in main memory. As mentioned just now, let's say you have different devices and different cache. So too many updates that you need to do. Why they say memory traffic problem and then bottleneck. So that's why another method is write back. So write back minimize a memory writes only in the cache. So portion of the main memory are invalid. Hence, access by IO modules can be allowed only through the cache. So that's why that has been is portion on the memory will be invalid. Okay, so only process in the cache memory. But this one makes a for complex circuitry and a partition. So you are doing for the complex circuit lah. Okay. Another one is write miss alternatives. There are two alternatives in the event of write miss at the cache level. Okay, write allocate or no write allocate. Okay, is the block containing the word to be written that fetched from the main memory into the cache, and the processor proceed with the write cycle. Okay, that one is write allocate lah. No write allocate, the block containing the word to be written is modified in the main memory into the cache. So either of this policy can be used, either we write through or write back. So this can be used with this these two kita panggil alternatives can be used either in or write back. Okay, so basically no write allocate is most commonly with the write allocate is most commonly used with the write back. Okay. So cache coherency. Okay, a new problem is introduced in bus organization which more than one device has a cache, as I say. Okay, and main memory is shared. Okay, you have number of devices that have its own cache, but the main memory is being shared by all these devices. Okay, as I say, if data in one cache are altered, this invalidates not only the corresponding word in memory, but also the same word in other caches. Okay, through policy issues, the other caches may contain the invalid data. They use the write back for the complex circuitry. Okay, possible approach to cache coherency includes watching with write through. Okay, each cache controller monitor the address line to detect any write operation. I think this one you can look onto the pipeline. Pipeline punya slide tadi, I think they have some explanation on this. If another master writes to a location in shared memory, they also reside in the cache memory, and then the cache controller will invalidate the cache entry. Okay, so then this strategy depends on the use of write through policy lah. Okay, or bus watching with write through ni, they have one monitor, kita panggil monitor the any process write in the cache. If we just drop it and so on lah. Okay, you boleh baca this one more details on your textbook. Additional hardware is used to ensure that all updates to main memory via cache are reflected in all cache. So this one is hardware transparency lah. So any cache, they will reflect into all the caches in. If one processor modifies a word in cache, this update also return to main memory. Okay. So non-cacheable memory, only a portion of memory is shared by more than one processor. So tak guna cache pun. Only the portion in the main memory akan be shared by all the shared by more than one processor. Okay, and then the all access to shared memory are cache miss. Because the shared memory is never copied into the cache lah, because tak ada the cache pun. Can be identified using the chip select logic or high address bit lah. So this one, so all this one is for the cache coherency problem. Okay, this is a line size. When a block of data is retrieved and placed in the cache, but also some number of edges now are retrieved lah. As the block size increase, hit ratio will the block size increase, hit ratio will at first increase because the locality. If you remember the principle of locality, semakin banyak block you ada, so hit akan ada lah. Betul tak? Number, all the data, block data ada dalam cache tadi. But all the block size increase, more useful useful data are brought into the cache. As the block size increase, more useful data brought into the cache. So the hit ratio will begin to decrease as the block become bigger. Probability of using the newly fetched information become less than the probability of reusing the information. So this is the problem when you increase the block size. So not block size, sorry, line size. Okay. Two specific effects come into play. Reduce the number of blocks that fit into the cache. As a block become larger, additional word is rather from the requested word. Because you block makin besar, your word bit akan menjadi lagi besar dan dia akan susah untuk dicapai dalam main memory. Okay. So then, they suggest a multi-level cache. Okay. So as logic density has increased, as the processor, the on-chip cache reduce the processor external bus and speed up the execution time, is the overall system performance. So when the requested instruction or data found in the on-chip cache will be eliminated lah. Okay, during this period, the bus is free to support other transfer. So kalau kita tengok, ada two level cache. L1 is the internal cache designated as level 1. So this is the highest level lah. External cache designated as a level 2. Okay. So potential savings due to the use of L2 cache depends on the heat rates in both the L1 and L2. On L2 being decided is based on the, as I said, same the programmer as the designer of the microprocessor. The use of multi-level cache is all of the design issue related to the cache, including size, replacement, and write policy. So this one is a unified versus a split cache. So has become common to split cache. Instruction one dedicated to data. So many kind of design you can see nowadays to cater the problem of the cache heat. Want to increase the cache heat, that's it. So many method technique has been studied and has been implemented in the number of processor design. Okay, unified lah. So advantage of unified cache, higher heat rate. Okay, and then advantage of split cache, unit cache potential contention between instruction, fetch decode unit and execution unit. Okay, so this one important in the pipeline lah, kalau split cache ni. Okay, this one is a inclusion policy. Inclusive policy dictates that a piece of data in one cache also found in lower level of cache. So one cache can be also found in the lower level lah. Okay. Advantage that is simplified searching for data when there are multiple processor. Exclusive policy dictates that a piece of data in one cache is guaranteed not to be found in all lower level of cache. So because it's a exclusive data lah. So only can be found in the high level of. The advantage is that it does not waste cache capacity, since it does not store multiple copy compared to inclusive. Inclusive, you must have the same data in L1, L2, and so on. Okay. Inclusive, non-inclusive policy, cache may or may not be found in lower level. Depends on the programmer. As with the exclusive policy, this policy will generally maintain all higher level cache set, first level cache. Okay, so this is the summary lah. Okay, for chapter 4, capture cache memory, the principle, cache time model design, and so the cache memory elements of the cache design, address, size, logical cache memory, replacement algorithm, write policy, line size, and so on. Okay, chapter 4. Alright, hopefully you understand lah. I think because it's not really difficult to understand this one. Right? So I will see you next week. I will lecture on next week, especially to prepare for your final. May I know that next week is your final week, right? Okay, yeah, so next week will be your final week. So kita prepare. Hopefully, all of you please attend, and then show you what's the hint for your final exam. What the time, I will inform you later on, but the same day is Monday. Because basically Dr. Tay will prepare for you a lecture slide. So I would like you to spend some of your time to go through the slide and then understand. If you don't understand Dr. Tay, and then maybe at 2 or 2:15 and so on, okay, we will do our class. I will inform you later on. Alright? So I think that's it for today. Any question, class? I think like I said, give me 1 week. 1 week, because we already marked some of the question. Okay, try to finalize. To ask. Marking the grade using the answer, and it's really hard because as usual, kita guna kertas, right? Okay, from there, we just mark. Here, government say it's a new norm. Okay, so give us some time. Okay, don't worry. Print it all out first. No need to print. We download it first. We need to download it first and look it one by one, digitally. Not if I print everything, bukan murah nak print lagi kertas. Okay, so basically we look onto digitally. Alright, so give us some time, maybe next week, end of next week. How many lab question until now? Only 2 lab. If you remember, in the first week of the class we told you that you will have 4 lab, right? 2 lab. Okay, the mark assessment also same, 20%. So you can understand lah. You submit 1 lab, 10%. You submit 2 lab, 20%. Okay, 2 lab question, and then the tutorial as mentioned by Tay lah, I think it's around 10 tutorial question. Okay. Any questions? Okay. So if you don't have any question, thank you very much. I don't think so. If no, I don't think so. Okay, I will talk to Dr. T. If anyone have, we just give. Even we didn't close the submission. We didn't close submission. I have to talk to Dr. T. And anyone who submit the lab tutorial, we just give the mark. Alright. Thank you very much for your time. If any inconvenience during the lecture, I'm so sorry. Okay, it's a new norm. We need to get used to it, adapt with this situation, with this environment. Alright, so thank you very much. I see you next week. No worries. Thank you. Alright, yeah, okay. I heard you coughing. Don't worry. Yeah? It's just because, you know, because talk too much. All right. Okay. Thank you very much for that. Okay. I see you next week. Dismiss lah. All right. Thank you. See you, everyone, and stay safe.